Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Kelvin here. Warren Buffett has always told us to invest in index funds. For Singaporeans, that index fund is the Straits Time Index or STI ETF. There are many articles and YouTube videos recommending STI ETF, saying that STI ETF is a good investment. However, in my humble opinion, I gently disagree with this view. STI ETF is not a good investment. If you want a good return on your money, stay far away from STI ETF. There's a lot to talk about, so let's start right now. STI ETF is just a benchmark for the Singapore stock market. The idea is that just by looking at STI ETF, you will know how well the Singapore stock market performs. Just like S&P 500 for United States, HSI Index for Hong Kong, KLCI for Malaysia. Good history on STI ETF. Long time ago, a guy named Sang Nila Utama came here and he saw a lion, so he named this place Singapura, which meant Lion City. Few hundred years later, STI ETF was created, which totally had nothing to do with Sang Nila Utama coming here. So I have no idea why I started from there. Anyway, STI ETF was created by SGX, SPH and FTSE Group. Every once in a while, the committee will meet up and review changes. Just like when you are young, there's a parent-teacher's day. And the teacher will tell your dad that you have been a naughty boy. And your dad will be like, later go home you will know. STI ETF consists of 30 blue chip companies in Singapore. And they were chosen based on their market capital and liquidity. Basically, the bigger the company is, the more traded the stock is, the more likely it will be chosen. It has a dividend yield around 4%, has an average return of 5.6% since inception. Those were just some quick info about STI ETF, and here's why some people think it is a good investment. The first reason, it is a bao ka liao or set meal. Think of a McDonald's set. When you buy McSpicy set, or also known as Mac Lao Sai, you'll get a burger, fries and drinks. Everything you need is in there already. So if you don't want to spend time choosing stocks or prefer to spend time on more important stuff like watching funny cat videos or watching Finding Nemo with your niece for the 10th time in a week, by buying one STI ETF, you will own the 30 largest companies in Singapore. Most of them are really good companies like DBS, where we save our money, Singtel, where we buy expensive iPhones to call one another, Ascendas, where a lot of offices are, CapitaLand, where we buy Gucci bag and Pao Pao Cha. You know, all the big companies that will still be around as long as Singapore is still around. A benefit of this is it is well diversified across many different companies and many different sectors. Even if one company doesn't do well, it still has 29 other companies to back it up. Second reason, STI ETF is self-cleansing. As mentioned earlier, there will be periodic committee reviews. The committee will decide which company to add in and which company to remove. So if any company doesn't do well, you'll be kicked out of the index. For example, they recently kicked out SPH and replaced with Mapletree Industrial Trust, which is awkward if you think about it because SPH helped to create the index, but the committee kicked it out instead. It's like when Harry Potter used Professor Snape's spell against himself. Anyway, because the index fund always replaces its holdings whenever they underperform, by just owning an index fund, you will not have to manage your portfolio. Everything is done automatically for you already. Well, not everything, because you still have to tap the like button to help support the channel. Third, you get the market's return. eToro found out that 75% of traders lose money. A research by Dalba found that average equity fund investors only earn a market return of 5.19%. CPF found that 40% of the CPF investors earn lesser than 2.5%. And over the long term, active fund managers underperform a simple index fund. The trend is quite clear. Many investors couldn't get the market's return. As the saying goes, if you can't beat them, buy it and shut it down. Wait, wrong quote. The right one is, if you can't beat them, join them. Rather than investing yourself to try to beat the market, when you try your best but you don't succeed, just invest in STI ETF instead. You will already beat most of the people out there. The fourth reason, STI ETF fees is very cheap. The fund has an expense ratio of 0.3%. So just by paying 0.3%, I will have all the hard work of stock picking and portfolio management done for me already. I don't have to study the company, time the market, and all those boring investing stuff, leaving me with more time to rewatch Game of Thrones. The 0.3% is very cheap when you compare them to mutual funds, which have at least 1% or more. With that being said, here's why I think STI ETF is a bad investment. First, historical performance. Starting from 1993, STI has delivered about 135%, which is actually pretty good. But compare that to HSI, which delivered 351%, and S&P 500, 698%. The STI pales in comparison. Remember that during this time, Singapore underwent one of its biggest transformations, becoming from a developing country to Asia's financial hub. And it was also during this time the Singapore dollar climbed against Malaysia ringgit, becoming SGD1 to RM3. If we zoom to the past 10 years, the Straits Time Index hasn't really gone anywhere. Keep in mind that before the pandemic came along, the past 10 years has been the best running bull market ever. With S&P 500 almost tripling in value, however, as what many people say, you can't predict future performance based on past performance. But unless Singapore can outperform itself in the future, STI doesn't look to be a good investment going forward. Second, lack of diversification. STI consists of the 30 biggest companies in Singapore. One look and you can already see everything. On top of that is 3 biggest holdings. DBS, OCBC, UOB makes up for over 1/3 of STI. As for the sectors, STI is super heavy in financial sector, which makes up for 62% of the index. Now, this won't come as a surprise as Singapore is a financial hub. However, let's look at S&P 500. Its top 3 holdings, Microsoft, Apple, Amazon, only makes up for 16% of the index. The tech sector is the largest at only 27%. So the S&P 500 is more diversified than STI because it feels to me that if I buy into STI, I'll be heavily in the financial sector. Now, this is alright when things are fine and banks are doing well. However, when things aren't going so well, like during recessions such as the 2008 financial crisis or even the current recession, banks will be underperforming. Already, you can see this happening with banks posting lower earnings due to bad loans. Compare that to the S&P 500, which made a wee for victory sign shaped recovery right after the crash. It's due to two reasons. The first is the unlimited cash cheat code, but more importantly, due to the good performance of the tech industry. Many tech companies like Amazon, Netflix, Microsoft have delivered profits during times like this. It's mainly because people can't leave their house or are required to work from home. So you will see more people watching Netflix, more people doing online shopping and any other tech-related activities. Speaking of strong companies, the S&P 500 has many strong companies while STI don't. Look at S&P 500. It has Google, Amazon, Microsoft, Apple, Facebook, Johnson & Johnson, Mastercard, Visa. The list just goes on and on. Like Johnson & Johnson was around even before my ama was born. Or those companies like Facebook and Google which we use on a daily basis. The S&P 500 feels like the Avengers where each superhero has their own unique abilities. On the other hand, if you look at STI companies, they don't really have a global presence. And most of them have already reached maturity, some even experiencing decline. Like Singtel, which is facing a lot of competition both in Singapore and outside of Singapore. Or even SPH, which is being removed recently. So if you invest in STI ETF, you can't really expect a fantastic return because most of the companies are already mature and can't really grow at a godlike pace. Personally, I still think that Singapore will remain relevant on the global stage and Singapore companies will be able to stay competitive, just not globally. So comes the next question. Then, how are? First of all, you have to accept that STI ETF is not fantastic by any means, but it can still have a place in your investing strategy. Even though STI return hasn't been fantastic, it has been delivering a good 4% dividend yield over the years. However, if you want a better return, you can just choose some of its holdings to invest instead. Many of its blue chips are extremely stable, like DBS, UOB, Ascendas, Mapletree Logistics, Mapletree Industrial are able to deliver a good 4-5% dividend yield every year. In fact, they have been steadily increasing their dividends over the years. The idea is that you only choose the good companies from this list, then build a strong dividend stock portfolio. There are 3 benefits to doing this. First, you rely on dividend payouts for your income. This is really important to me because it coincides with my financial independence plan. You see, to achieve financial independence, your passive income just needs to be higher than your expense. And the benefit of relying on dividend for your income is that you do not rely on stock price for your income. Because of that, you won't be affected by stock market crash or any crazy price fluctuations. All you need to do is just buy and hold the good dividend paying companies and receive dividends every quarter. And over time, with the power of compounding, your passive income will be high enough to allow you to retire. Another benefit is you avoid currency risk. By investing overseas, you will be exposed to currency risk. For example, if you invest in Malaysia stock market, you might possibly see SGD1 to RM4. Not that I say it will, it just has this possibility. Or even the United States from 2003 to 2011. You can see that USD has dropped against SGD. So even though your investments have grown, when you convert back to SGD, the currency price drop will still reduce your returns. By investing in local stocks, you won't have to deal with this kind of risk. Third, you won't be taxed on your dividends. Unlike the United States, which has a 30% withholding tax, Singapore government doesn't tax you on your dividend income. Thank sky, thank floor. What it means is for every $100 you receive in US dividends, Uncle Sam takes 30% of it, then thanks you for nation building. But by investing in SDI or local stocks, you do not have to pay anything. Whatever you earn is 100% yours. In summary, even though STI ETF has a lower return compared to other indexes, it is not a 100% bad investment. You can still invest in STI ETF or choose good stocks from its holdings to build your dividend portfolio, which may be well suited to your investing strategy when you are nearing retirement. And that's all for today. Let me know down in the comments below, what are your thoughts? Are you investing in STI ETF? Like, share, and subscribe, as I'll be posting new videos every Monday. See ya!